And welcome back to today's video. This time I'll be playing on the Russian side, pushing back into North Orsha. We've set up a couple of lighthouses, one of which is going to drop some smoke here. Reason why is because while we make this advance up into these buildings, we're hoping that anything that is pushing through this road will be able to get smoked, so our guys can fully move up without coming under fire. Allies decided to help us by also bringing up a T-34E and some AA and Strasniki. Meanwhile, I'm just bringing up three Strasniki into these buildings and three over into these buildings. Unfortunately, the smoke didn't get there in time, and they did manage to spot me as we were driving off. So we're just trying to unload these into this forest now. And now I'm dropping some artillery onto them to brought up this SU-85 to try to take on any armor that they pull up, which I think did take out a few of my allies' units. And then we're just now moving Strasniki over into this forest. Some big left enemies moved up, which unfortunately the Red Horse leader. Managed to take out their chief. Now I just noticed this half track also moved up. Close quarters is just going to blow these guys down. I was trying to get these guys into this building to try to get cover fire as they retreated. Probably still lost the majority of the squad. Mortar fire seems to knock them back out. And as we start to bring up a T-34 and a sniper squad, some AA to try to defend this road if any infantry come out. Sanitar! We're also bringing this SU-84 over to this side. Now that we've spotted these thugs that are holding up the road. T-31st puts one and they start exchanging. Also bringing up this artillery unit. Oh no, sorry, anti-tank unit. Place to try to also move down the stocks. Just moving them forward a little bit. T-34 does lose that exchange, but the SU-85 makes a nice clean shot up on this thug's side armor, taking it out. So just look at that half track that is pushing forward.
Yeah.
refugees who set up in this village. As we move our SU-5 and 4 closer, I will try to remove this armor, along with a anti-tank gun. Left in this area that we need to avoid. I will put our second SU-85 there. Stug manages to take out my SU-85. I was targeting the wrong vehicle. Unfortunately, we lost the T-34 because I wasn't getting any help from the SU-5. Our anti-tank's up now. Oh, I still managed to take out the SU-5. So remove that armor from this center here. We don't have any units yet to push back on this town, but as soon as phase B begins, we'll be able to start a new push up into this town. So phase B has begun and we're starting to move up the units of the GPs. We've also brought up the strategy to this part of the forest that we can start supporting. We've put a couple of T-34Es as well, which now that that arm has been dealt with, shouldn't have any trouble dealing with their infantry. Some recon coming up. Great thing about the pretty much the same as a infantry unit. They can push through the infantry. They just track their elements. A little firefighting that's been going on between these buildings and these rooms. Into a position to keep this town well defended.
Sanitar!
This was a little bit too risky. But we didn't realize that there was actually a whole bunch of units just waiting for us to go. because of my lack of AA, which Soviet battle group lacks this fighter in the skies. You and our yak have plenty of opportunity to come in with a bomb run. As of now, we've got our just MG. But they did take that out. What do you expect? Let's go with my yak to go deal with these bombers that they've brought in. Here they may have a bit of a push with their strong pioneers. Get out, what am I supposed to do? Hit and run. Shotguns. But he does manage to get a flame off him. We got some sappers in the back. Pushing up these T-34s. So that we can really move up into these buildings. I think they've got an ID in this building. I did notice those he was getting a little bit too close here and we've lost vision of them, so I'm just pulling my T-34s back so they don't get hit with any anti-tank. And if ME-109 comes in, I have to do a straight run. And that just took him out. You know, a couple of fun things. There's another one that takes out my light howitzer. Because of my lack of AA, there's just nothing I can really do against that at this point in time. As my fighter was in the. Sappers have moved up now though, so this flag's back under control. I've just brought up some AA now. And my yak. Trying just to take out that fighter. I to roll that head-on collision. Let's just pull out some units to help me here. I'm going to try and clear off these paper pioneers. Which is now giving me room to move up these tapers. Sapper's running into a little bit of difficulty now. This one, please. Suppressing him as his flat. Having a little bit of difficulty trying to deal with these MG units. I'm just putting up my gas. From the AA, so unfortunately I have lost control of the spires. I'm gonna move a couple of eagle squares to the spires, so I'm leaving them to my storm VT, which have their dual flamethrowers in their use. Do some barrages on them first. Now I'm just going to move these T-34s up to here to try to help, if we can try to get some sort of push over to these buildings here with the sapping stuff up there. That's my key. 34. Just pushed up to here. That was with this ZSU M15, was probably the best. AA the Soviets had for this deck. So it was just lucky that I brought that up in the nick of time. And we are now pushing up with the rest of our units. We want to secure this forest before pushing down into this town. Put some flame tanks. I think that's where my AA used to be. Didn't realise that I was actually moving it forward. And now moving up these guards here to help with the push and just to hold this. Yeah, moving up into this forest here. I'm going to get to the cross a flat. Flamethrowers make quick work of them there, which is good. Secure this. Let's bring up some supplies for our T-34 so again. Running out of machine guns. Plenty of HP shows here. charge on their artillery.
Sanitar!
Let's try and move these guys over here just to keep hold of this flag. Out of range of these artillery strikes I'm doing here. Because we weren't able to defeat. So the buildings, put more cobbles around these ridges, and they're going to come straight into it, 234, and guard the units. Even if they do manage to take this, we can always just push forward with our troops and knock them out of the way. Recapturing this forest. Try to build up the stud. See what my tank rifles shooting. Let's go there. Pull back, but we won't actually do the efficient blood, I think. So I'm just moving up these forest machines into this town now. Pretty much secured this forest, so I thought it'd be easier just to move them along up here. I've also brought up some 120mm mortars for cover. Are actually able to hit this heavy howitzer all the way here. And I think, just dropping some more mortars into it to finish it off. And also mortaring this IG-33, that was kind of going to harass my enemy. Yeah, so we managed to push and hold this cliff, and also manage to push and hold this town. Yeah, thanks for watching. I've got the stats here, 2700 to 1700, not too bad. It was just quite fun playing as a Soviet.